Greetings, everybody. Welcome back to our podcast on the category of Ancient Wisdom Demystified. Today's topic are the two great catastrophes. So, Tata.
Yes, dear.
What were the two great catastrophes that happened?
Well, this is very important from the type of dating that we got to look at. We were talking about the Egyptian civilization. And so, in that context, this becomes very important. First major disaster or catastrophe was around the year 42,000. This is called the last chance magnetic pole reversal.
Yes.
Once in a way, the magnetic pole reverses, and we will see about it in much more detail. The second catastrophe happened around 12 to 11,000 years ago, and that was the Younger Dryas days. So, in between these two catastrophes was the period in which the Egyptian civilization that we see today started flourishing. The technologies that you had, as we discussed about the pyramids and the Sphinx and all that, and the temples, actually flourished during the time between the first and the second catastrophe.
Okay.
That is why these two dates are important.
Nice.
So, we will talk about this particular catastrophes today, but we will go into the period prior to the last chance, 42,000, in a series on which we will be dealing about the Sumerian civilization.
Okay, so they were before the before last chance.
Yes.
Okay.
So,
what is the last chance magnetic pole reversal all about?
Yeah, see, once in a way, once in 200,000 to 300,000 years, their magnetic field normally shifts completely around. North becomes south and south becomes the north. And this reversal is rather very gradual. And it happens, as I told you, between this type of time period. The last particular pole reversal took place around 42,000 years ago. This, what was unique about this particular reversal was it lasted only for about 1,000 years, which is a very small amount of time in the age of the earth. So, what happened during that particular time is Earth lost most of its magnetic field. It was only 28% of the normal.
Okay.
Which is very disastrous for us because, you know, we are protected from cosmic rays and solar flares only because of the magnetic field.
Okay, so what sort of cosmic rays, like what would they do to us if they didn't?
See, if we are not protected from cosmic rays, then cell mutation takes place.
Okay. Okay.
And we can have
like cancer,
and other things can happen. If you, how did they find out that this happened 42,000 years ago?
Yeah.
It's because of the carbon dating. Because carbon normally is only having an atomic number of 6.
Yeah.
But they found an abundance of carbon 14 at this particular point of time.
Okay.
See, and they, what they did was they had fossils, especially one fossil which really proved some big disaster happened was the kauri tree in the marshlands of New Zealand. They were very old and very long living trees.
Okay.
They were fossilized and they were able to recover this fossil and do the carbon dating. And they found a very high level of carbon 14.
Nice.
So, also we find during this particular time that we had the extinction of megafauna. All the large animals disappeared. And also we had the Neanderthal man who almost co-inhabited with Homo sapiens at that time.
Okay.
Because they were much more exposed compared to the people or Homo sapiens who lived inside the caves. So they were completely eliminated. They were completely destroyed because of the cosmic ray bombardment and what happened in nature. And they were depending on, they were all hunter-gatherers. So most of the animals disappeared. This is the reason why the Homo sapiens survived, but the Neanderthals disappeared.
Okay, so we branched off from them.
Yeah, we branched off from them, but they were parallelly living. And now, because of this particular catastrophe, we became the dominant species on this earth.
Were there any Neanderthals left, do you think, after the disaster?
No, I don't think much of them. There were few people and they could not survive because, you know, they could not procreate. Something, you know, radical happened during that period. But we have Neanderthal blood. That's, of course, another subject.
Okay.
We, in our genes, we have got indication that we all carry some amount of the Neanderthal gene. Because which means there was some crossbreeding between the Homo sapiens and the Neanderthal. Anyway, this short video illustrates two events which are of primary importance to us. Around 35,000 years ago, we had the Phlegrean volcanic eruption, a major eruption that took place. And that devastated most of the Southeast Europe and had a great influence on the Egyptian civilization. Also, around 42,000, you had the magnetic pole shift, which is called the Lachance pole shift. And this reduced the magnetic field to a large extent. This resulted in cosmic ray bombardment and other natural catastrophes, including solar flare, which could penetrate easily and affect human beings, flora and fauna. You can see this, how fast the poles shifted, by looking at the lines which are drawn on the global map which you have here, and also the period of only 1,000 years to shift back from north to south and south to north.
That's
a separate topic.
Okay.
Now, we'll talk about the next disaster now.
Yeah, sure.
The Younger Dryas Days.
Younger Dryas Days.
So, the Younger Dryas Days is something which happened around, as I told you, 12,000 to 11,000 years ago. And what really happened at that time was there's a comet. This is the most probable theory. There's a comet called Clovis Comet, which is around 4 miles long.
Okay,
in diameter also. And this fragmented. It came very near to the Earth.
Okay.
We have got quite a lot of comets and meteorites which are passing very close to the Earth, but they disintegrate in the atmosphere. But being a large comet, this disintegrated into 4 parts. One fell in America, the other one fell in Europe, in Greenland, and the next one somewhere in the Middle East and that area. Then one was even further fragmented and fell somewhere else.
Okay.
So this was just like a spread global event. Of meteorites or a comet strike.
Yeah.
And that because of that, the temperature dropped. Because when the comet strikes, you raise up a lot of dust and debris. And that makes a complete cover over the Earth.
Okay.
And it takes a long time to settle down. Hundreds of years. And so what happened? There's no sunlight. When there's no sunlight, you lose your very basic things for your plants. Your animals, everything.
Yeah, living
things. People, all living things are affected when there is no sun. One of the reasons we find that they were able to trace back to this 12 to 14,000 years when this particular Younger Dryas Days happened. The platinum spike. Because platinum is not an abundant element in the Earth.
Yeah.
It happens only when a meteorite or a comet strikes, because they carry what they call as a extraterrestrial
platinum. Okay, mad.
Platinum is a rare material, and they can, they are not found in abundance here. Address this. The main thing that happened was a temperature drop. You had in fact, there was a time when we were coming out of the ice age.
Okay.
From around 20,000 years ago, we are coming out. And at about 14,000 years to 12,000 years, this happened. And because of that, completely the temperature dipped. Africa was one of the biggest countries which was affected by this particular Younger Dryas Days.
Okay.
Also, they found a 31-kilometer crater in Greenland. And the Hiawatha Glacier.
Okay, inside a glacier.
Part, because when you have the glacier accumulating all the snow and the ice, inside this ice they found this particular clear, which is a clear indication there was a comet strike.
Okay, nice.
So, these are the things that we see. And so, most of the animals disappeared again during this period of time. And we had, and it was like a trans-global event.
Okay.
All over the place, we had this problem of life going extinct. The people who were, especially since we are interested in Egypt, the people who had higher technology, what they did was, some of them were able to go into the pyramids. In fact, pyramids today, if you go in, they got a lot of chambers. Why was the chambers built? Because it cannot be for a record keeping.
Yeah, but one of the theories was that, you know, when the mummies come back to life, they're going to use it to escape or something like that.
Yeah.
That's what I heard.
But that's all okay. That's all fairy tale. And, the kings were buried there because there was, the king's chamber where it's in the pyramid has got a location where maximum energy can be there.
Okay.
So they can be taken to afterlife in a very pleasant way.
Okay.
But, mummies coming back to life and all that,
sci-fi. Okay, yeah. So what actually was the purpose of these underground?
So that's what we don't know. But now, if you look at all this destruction and catastrophe that took place, probably the people who lived between the 42,000 to 14,000 years, they had a higher knowledge about what's happening in an astronomical level.
Okay.
Well, so what they did was being prepared. They took shelter under these pyramids. There's a lot of caves around the Egyptian, northern Egypt and around that area where the pyramids are. There's a valley called the Valley of the Kings.
Yeah.
So they got a lot of caves and a lot of, so people who had this knowledge could escape and then be there for some time till the earth revived. And they could have, and so Africa, like last time we talked about the Sphinx.
Yeah.
So a green cover.
Green cover.
The green cover was lost due to the second, during
the Younger Dryas days.
Younger Dryas days, yes.
Okay.
So this is the thing we have to, take into consideration. So it's a nice discussion on the two catastrophes.
Yeah.
And you can see the linkages between the Sumerian, then the higher advanced Egyptian civilization between the two disasters or catastrophes. And then you had the new civilization or new, culture coming in of the pharaohs and other people who came after 10,000 BC.
Okay.
So, this is the story now.
Nice.
Good. Okay. Thank you for the lovely, dialogue.
Thank you too.
So, we'll have more discussion on this in the coming episode.
Sure.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So, bye. See you.
Bye.